Welcome back. This is a P3D flight that I'm planning. We're going to do the next leg of catch-up fill, and I'm here in Aleppo at the moment. Let's try and get a grip on that. OSAP, Aleppo International Airport, just inside the border from of Syria from Turkey over here. I think it's Turkey. It is Turkey. And we are going to head her off down the line. We have a little bit of a trip that's going to make our way. We're going to fly over this airport just so that I have an airport to fly over on the route. And we're essentially going to travel about 450 nautical miles, so it's about 4 hours flying. And this is the route we're heading down to this VORDME of DORZ. And then I've set a waypoint here as a little bit of a kind of a island landmark as we head down towards Baghdad, where there's another VOR. I believe it's a VOR in Baghdad. And let's have a quick look here. BDG, it's a VOR, yeah. And we are going to land here on this Sheikh Hantush highway strip, which will be interesting. And that'll kind of get us a good maybe half the way. The next leg is going to take us down into the Doha region, but we'll plan that a little bit later. So we're using VFR Flight here, which is a free downloadable VFR flight planning tool that you can tie in with the data that's in your FSX or your P3D. At some point in time, it may or may not include the Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020. Right now, it doesn't. I do think Navigraph are working on building a VFR flight planning chart system and tool. Also, excuse me, yawn just came in out of nowhere. But for most of my planning right now, I work with this tool. It's a good tool, but it's not perfect. It does run into a few problems here and there. Kind of catches up and freezes. I think it's a 32-bit tool. It needs Java. There's a few little parts to it that kind of make it not difficult to set up, but you know, there's a few more steps involved. So we're going to be flying the Comanche with one M, but I've written it with two. And we have some of the basic profile performance characteristics. 9,500 feet is what I'm choosing to fly at here. It's going to be mostly flat terrain as far as I can tell. If I zoom in here, we're looking at 2,400. But over the flight path, we're all less than 3,000 feet anyway. So I'm going for 9 for just a little bit of performance. Don't really need to go much higher than that. I think that's going to work for me. So the planning route, as you can see, we're leaving Aleppo here and then we're picking up an MDB. We're flying over OS-59, which is just a land strip field. Then we're over the VORDME of Delta Romeo Zulu, whatever that is. Then I have put this waypoint in. I suppose I could give this waypoint a name. Let's change the name of this waypoint and give it something useful. So this will be Lake, L-A-K-E, can't type, Lake Land Point. What happened? Okay, we'll just leave it as Lake then, that works too. Then we're over the Baghdad VOR, and then we need to track from that Baghdad VOR on a magnetic course of 146 for 44 miles to pick up this landing here. So there's not really an awful lot of nav aids to look at here, so we're going to have a little bit of fun, I think, trying to find this. But hey, that's the deal, and maybe we'll see how we get on. One of the big advantages that Microsoft 2020 is bringing is that it has Bing Maps in there, so the expectation is that we would have a much higher detailed actual map underneath us, and consequently we can use relatively good real world planning tools and expect to be able to follow it in the sim. I'm using Google Earth terrain information here, so my expectation is that the general roads and tracks and stuff that are in here, the lake positions, promontories and all the rest, are relatively decent, paddy. But I'm playing P3D with Orbix, and we'll find out how well they map up or match up. We're going to bring these VOR informations with us. There's only a couple that I need. To be honest with you, I don't think I need them all. Let's make a decision then. So I don't need BL. ALE I'm going to leave in, though. That's the NDB, and I'm not using it. So, and I'm not using that NDB either, so get rid of that too. All of this I don't need for sure. I am going to use the MER. I'm not going to use these two NBDs. I am going to use this 4 and this DME. So Droz is a little further up on the plan, isn't it? Yeah, so let's... Well, that's fine. I mean, we're just having that for information, so... So that's good, very good, very good. Alternate airports, weather window, wind and all that kind of stuff, I'm not really going to worry about. So, hope this works now. But if I hit save, it says that the flight plan is saved. And if I hit create, then we'll stick in Aleppo, we'll overwrite it. Yes, I do want to overwrite it. And then we will open it up. Let's see, does it open up? And here it is. This is the flight plan, the aircraft, the pilot, and the name. We can put that information in pointsels. The wind, we have zeroed out the wind right now. We have a cruising speed and altitude that has been set. And then we have our legs, and this is how it's looking. So it's all fitting onto one page, essentially. Unfortunately, that information tripped over. But we have our first leg, which has a track of 096. Magnetic track of 061, there's 5 degrees variance in there. A wind correction angle, we've put in a zero because we haven't actually put in any weather. A distance of 4.1 nautical miles. An expected ground speed of 75 knots. On a magnetic heading of 091. And it'll take us approximately 3 minutes to get there. The VOR information will be these... on a radial of 092 for 9 nautical miles, and then DRZ is on a radial of 287 for 148 nautical miles. And we're thinking we're going to be there in 3 minutes, and we'll find out what our actual travel time is. So I can fill this in as I go along. Pretty, pretty, huh? So the same then for the next leg, and then the next leg, and this is our lake, and then for lake to Baghdad, and then from Baghdad to the Strip. So in terms of time, we're up to an hour and a half, 2.5 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours. We do have that 5 degrees magnetic declination in there. We're thinking that we're going to use about 55 gallons. So, yeah, we'll see how we get on. Then we can put in our safe altitude, which is about, and a minimum safe altitude, I think, is about 3,200. But we're going to be traveling at a little bit higher, three times that. We can put in a departure time and an arrival time, and these are our frequencies for that. So it'd be nice if we could get this all onto one page. But it'll print over onto the back of the other page anyway, so that'll be there. This is not for operational use, of course. So we'll close that. In terms of weather, I suppose we could pop in some weather right now. We get the current information. Maximum distance from route. So if we download, there's a connection error, so that doesn't work. No routes for that, clear also. Yeah, weather, I haven't really pushed to try and get that in. We'll do a little bit of an update on weather, possibly offline, see if I can get that working. But that's the plan, Stan. It's a great plan, and we'll be flying it in the Kompota, in the Futa. On until the next time, thanks for watching.